Sorry, I'm back now. I'm using my hubby's phone instead of mine because it's not working right. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go and post my dream up, the whole thing, and let you guys know what it is. Okay, I had a dream last night that more than a few of us were outside and we were hanging out and we were talking. And then it was like a tornado hit us, and it was weird because this tornado looked like a cloud, like a white cloud or almost like snow. And I was like, what the heck is that? And then, then I turned around to look at it, and we just pretty much ran inside him just to avoid what it was. And I noticed that it was like an extremely weak or light one. Like, it wouldn't do much damage to us. And then I noticed that, later on during the same night, that there was a ton of us again outside watching the sky, talking, just relaxing, chilling, hanging out. And I stood up, and because I had noticed something really weird falling from the sky. And what I had noticed was there was a ton of stars falling from the sky ferociously and fast. And I tried to grab it to, you know, desires to look at the stars. And when I told my husband about it, I was like, you know, we just read about the stars falling from the sky the other day, or, you know, recently or stuff, you know, in the Bible. And then this was right around the nighttime, like when my husband was sleeping, and this was at the beginning time of when he usually sleeps. But later on, during everything occurring like this, he wasn't sleeping at this time. He was outside with me. This was occurring during nighttime. I noticed that again. My little girl was with us outside as well. The next thing I saw is I was in this building, and it was like a church, and it was a slash gym area. And there was food on the tables. And they would set food on the tables, and they bring food in bags, in plastic bags. I saw that. And then I got on the microphone in this church, and I told him, I said out loud on this microphone, I said, and the next thing that would happen would be the heavens would be shaken. And just as I said that, shortly we were back outside again, and then there was a huge earthquake, had to be 9-10 or so. And we had nowhere to run, and we couldn't find anywhere to run because it was that quick and that fast. So what we did is we laid on the cement. And as we laid on the cement, like the earthquake came and it split the cement some, but we were fine. My husband walked over and he grabbed up my little girl, and we all walked off together. Not many people were injured in this as well, so. Let's see. I picked up my little girl and we got my hubby. Shortly later after the earthquake, we saw a blood moon in the sky, and it was more on the left side of the sky. And I noticed that it was like things were happening back to back to back, as I noticed. And then afterwards, when everything was done at this time, somehow we ended up back in this ginormous gymnasium, and then we saw, tons of tables and bleachers that people were sitting everywhere, and we recognized people that we knew, or, you know, brothers and sisters in Christ and family and stuff that we knew, there. And then we ended up seeing this announcer on the microphone, and we all looked to the right. We ended up all looking to the right side, and as we looked to the right side, we noticed these angels were coming out the right side. They were wearing, they had white wings, and they were dressed in all white, and we noticed that. And there was quite a few ones. And the next thing we saw was after the angels. Now, this part really got me. This part was really interesting to me. The announcer had said, and now introducing Jesus Christ. I was so happy at that time. And side note, I did write down how Jesus looked in my dream as well. And usually when I see Jesus in visions and dreams, he has light that shines from him, really bright white light that shines from him as well. And then the Lord was speaking to all of us while we were sitting on the bleachers and sitting at these tables and stuff, because this was the gym here. There was tables all along the backside area, and there were bleachers on the other side where we were at. Then I saw so many people there that we recognized, and we were talking to, and we were happy, and we were joyful, and I saw that. And then I saw Jesus sitting behind us as if he was watching over everybody there, all of us there. I remember I was tired, because I was yawning in the dream, but I didn't fall asleep. And the Lord was, like, behind me, and he nudged me a little bit with his hand on my shoulder. Then we all got up, and the Lord was reminding us all of something important that he wanted each of us to know. Just something special, like something important that he wanted each of us to know. He went to my husband and asked him to look up something from 2014, something that he forgot about. And then all of a sudden, I saw his face, my husband's face, because he was like, oh, wait a minute, I know what it is. Then he ran out to go get it or to go grab it. I don't know what it is either. So only he does. Then the announcer says, some of us had events we had signed up for and some of us didn't. We all belonged to the Lord and we were all happy. The ones with the events had to stay in to do those events. Now, what I mean when I say events is I meant, like, some of us wanted just to relax and to sit there and to be with the Lord and everything. And, like, the Lord didn't leave us or anything like that. We were all together. And some, they wanted to get there and they were like, we want to do this. We want to play games. We want to, you know, go out and do stuff, you know, while the Lord's there. Yeah, like I said, the Lord was still with us and we were still with the Lord. When I got in the idea in this dream was of fun things and games, I think. That way, then way later on in my dream, I was in a business type of building, and I had woken up from a dream inside of a dream. So I woke up twice. I was sweating profusely, and I had an extremely urgent message for these people that were sitting at this huge business type building at the tables. I told them what was coming and how close everything really was and that they needed to repent and Jesus is here and they need to make a decision pretty much now what they were going to do. Because I had noticed at this time that, one, they didn't believe me. Two, they were eating, drinking, smoking, marrying, all this stuff. And then later on, I saw a different area where I showed up to this one girl and this guy who were living together. I don't know if they were married or not. They were just living together. I told them because that they didn't believe me and what I was saying, that the Lord was going to speak to them directly. And he did speak them to directly through me. His voice was deep and it was strong. I remember this. It was almost like a sound of many waters or oceans. So it was deep and strong, and it was an extremely serious message for them. This dream was interesting, but towards the end, more towards the end of this dream, I had saw the same girl, but this time she had, I guess, had some kind of heart attack in this dream, and she ended up having to, we ended up having to call an ambulance for her to get in the ambulance and to get her off to the hospital. I don't know what happened after that because I woke up after we sent her off to the hospital. Also, I got this dream to be an extremely urgent warning from the Lord with how close the timing is. And like I said, I also woke up twice from this dream as well. Like, I woke up with a dream within a dream, and then I woke up the second time as well from this. But I did want to get this out there, and I definitely want to post this up, and I love you all, and God bless you all, and please take this one seriously and discern this message. Well, I should say this dream from the Lord. Okay. Love y'all. Thinking about actually doing a song for you guys, too. Let me see here. What should I do? I got one. All right, give me a second here. Here's one.
Your brain is like a hungry sponge. It's
Oh, what I would do to have the kind of faith it takes to climb out of this boat and then onto the crashing waves. Step out of my comfort zone into the realm of the unknown where Jesus is. And he's holding out his hands. And waves are calling out my name and they laugh at me. Reminding me of all the times I tried before and failed. Reminds me, keep on telling me time and time again, boy, you'll never win. You'll never win. But the voice of truth tells me a different story. The voice of truth says do not be afraid. And the voice of truth says this is for my glory. Out of all the voices calling out to me, I will choose to listen and believe the voice of truth. Oh, what I would do strength it takes to stand before a giant.
We're just a sling in the stone,
surrounded by the sound of a thousand warriors shaking in their armor, wishing they'd have had the strength to stand. But the giant's calling out my name, he laughs at me, reminding me of all the times I've tried before. Time and time again, boy, you'll never win. You'll never win. But the voice of truth, it tells me a different story. The voice of truth, it says do not be afraid. And the voice of truth says this is for my glory. Out of all the voices calling out to me, I will choose to listen and believe the voice of truth.
That's what I got for you guys for now. Thank you. Bye-bye.